The Great Indian Bustard. Sounds like I'm abusing someone, but I am actually talking about a bird. A critically endangered bird that was once a candidate to be the national bird of India, but is now seen as a nuisance to India's green goals. How did this bird go from being a national icon to a villain in India's environmental movement? And is this justified? Today, we discuss. The Great Indian Bustards live in the grasslands of Rajasthan, Gujarat, Maharashtra, and Karnataka. Now, these areas are also prime locations for solar and wind energy projects. That is bad news for the birds because they have some habits and characteristics that don't allow them to coexist with renewable energy projects. Great Indian Bustards tend to fly low, look towards the ground while flying. Even if they tried to look at what's in front of them, they can't focus because they have poor eyesight, and they can't turn very quickly while flying because they are large and heavy. So they are quite shocked when they crash into a power transmission line and get electrocuted. There are about 100 Great Indian Bustards left in India. According to a Wildlife Institute of India report, approximately 18 die every year by crashing into power transmission lines. On top of this, their habitats, the grasslands, are termed as revenue wastelands in the government records. This makes it very easy to convert this land into agricultural fields, industrial parks, or renewable energy projects. All in all, the situation doesn't look good for the Great Indian Bustards. If things continue as they are, they will be extinct in the next few years. So in April earlier this year, the Supreme Court of India responded to a petition on this matter and ruled that all power transmission lines in priority and potential Great Indian Bustard habitats must go underground immediately. This increases the cost of solar and wind energy projects in these areas by several crores of rupees. Some estimate that up to 20 gigawatts of renewable energy generation could be affected by this. Naturally, the project developers are not happy. Some news outlets have reported this ruling with a very weird narrative. According to these reports, this ruling sacrifices the bigger environmental goal of renewable energy generation to protect these birds because India's climate goals heavily rely on its ability to scale renewable energy generation in the country. That's how the Great Indian Bustard is suddenly the villain in India's climate movement. This story is an example of a very one-dimensional narrative in environmental protection. A narrative where environmental protection is just reducing greenhouse gas emissions and mitigating climate change. The same thing happened during the Aray Forest controversy in 2020. Here, the forests were being cleared to make way for the Mumbai Metro network, which supporters claimed would remove many cars from the road and reduce carbon emissions. Okay. But what about everything else that the Aray Forest was doing? This was a mature forest ecosystem that was home to a variety of urban wildlife, regulated air temperatures, improved local air quality, and played a big role in controlling urban floods, something that Mumbai sees a lot of. Compensating for the forest being felled by planting trees in other locations is not going to restore all of these ecosystem services that community experienced. The environment is more than just carbon emissions and climate change. The environment provides us with several ecosystem services. All of these services need to be safeguarded, or at the very least, be considered in a cost-benefit analysis. In the case of the Great Indian Bustards, it seems like the news articles are saying that it's okay to let one bird go extinct as long as we can scale our renewable energy generation cheaply and quickly. But saving the Great Indian Bustards is not just about preventing one species' extinction. To protect these birds, we need to protect their habitat, the grasslands. The grasslands are a unique ecosystem. It provides livelihoods to thousands of grazers and herders who are the backbone of India's meat and dairy industry. It's home to a variety of wildlife like the lesser florican, McQueen's Bustard, and other threatened species. It regulates local climate and controls soil erosion. Grasslands are also excellent carbon sinks. The amount of carbon that they capture and store depends on how the grassland is being managed, and scientists are still studying this process, But one 2014 study found that the grasslands of the world can capture and store 200 to 800 million tons of carbon dioxide equivalent every year by the year 2030. And in case you need a refresher, one of India's climate goals is to increase the carbon sink in the country by 2.5 to 3 billion tons of carbon dioxide equivalent by 2030. India currently plans to do this only through forest and tree cover, but grasslands can and should be part of this goal. So the narrative that these news articles have propagated is wrong. The Great Indian Bustards are not standing in the way of India's climate goals. Protecting the Great Indian Bustards safeguards a lot of ecosystem services and can potentially contribute to India's green goals. Perhaps people don't know or understand about ecosystem services, or it's a case of deliberately creating a false narrative to serve profit motives. See, I'm not against renewable energy. Renewable energy is good for the planet, and we do need to scale up renewable energy in the country. But this ruling is also not against renewable energy generation. It just asks project developers to make some modifications. Yes, that incurs an additional cost, but given the strong political will behind renewable energy generation in the country, I think that this funding can be arranged. Also, solar and wind projects can be taken up in other locations. Great Indian Bustards have just one habitat. This ruling is not a case of choosing nature over development or sacrificing India's green goals. This is what sustainable development looks like. It is complicated. It requires you to consider several aspects of nature, several different ecosystem services. But it is a way to develop and protect nature. The Supreme Court bench that made this ruling recognized this when they said that despite cost implications, they want to balance development with the rights of other creatures. And I see nothing wrong with that. What do you guys think? Is the Supreme Court ruling too harsh? Was there a better way to save the Great Indian Bustards? Let me know in the comments. I'd like to thank Lakhan Patidar who helped me make the Hindi subtitles for this video. I hope you liked that, and if you did, let me know so that I can make this a regular feature on this channel. If you liked this video, consider sharing it with others who might also enjoy it. It's always nice to grow the family, and it'll help us achieve our vision, which is to make the world ecologically intelligent.